Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to the session on TMTI series 30 images in OBGY and OFCAT. My name is Dr. Janvi and I'm the Unacademy educator in anesthesia. And we have been running this series each and every day now. So I welcome all of you all. We've done so many TMTI series. I hope it was useful for this month and I plan to continue this TMTI series into the next month. Please do let me know if you guys want any topics to be covered in images. I know a lot of you are saying microbiology and pathology. So we'll start moving more towards the second year subjects now for images. So let's begin with today's class. Welcome to Unacademy. The plus subscription will give you access to live and recorded classes. You can get live tests, quizzes, question bank, and printed notes if you buy a more than 12-month subscription. The iconic subscription is in partnership with PrepLadder, in which you get the live lectures of Unacademy and the video lectures of PrepLadder. In all our special classes, we have all these features. They are absolutely free. You can interact with the educator, you get polls, you can ask questions, you get lecture notes, and you can watch it anytime, anywhere with an internet connection. This is our question bank with 25,000 high yield questions. These are our batches that have started yesterday. Focus FMG batch for December FMG students. Target next 2023 integrated batch, in which we will be doing system-wise coverage, like CVS from all subjects, then we'll have RS from all subjects, like that. Professional year 2 batch and NEET PG Ultra Fast Track High Yield Revision batch. This is the 1 month package for NEET PG. You can see that you will get high yield revision, PYQs, emergency-based scenarios, COVID scenarios, test analysis and grand test series. These are our grand test schedule and these are some offers that are going on right now. So you can buy a 12-month subscription, get 2 months free. You can also buy the 4-year subscription. And this is my code, Dr. Janvi Live, if you would like to buy the plus subscription, with which you will get a 10% off on your subscription. All right, so let's begin with our class for today. So today we have all the instruments from OBGY. I have put like around 40 instruments from OBGY, which they keep asking again and again in the exam. So some simple instruments, but some are extremely specific and you need to know the instruments. So we'll quickly be doing the instrument and its use. Instrument and its use, okay? So first instrument, can you guys identify this for me? Can anyone identify this for me? This is the easiest instrument. It's used not just in OBGY, but also in surgery. If you want, I'll zoom in and show you. Yes, this is your artery forceps. Artery forceps. So here I've given you both the artery forceps. This is the straight one and this is the curved one. Now you all will say, ma'am, ye kya dikha rahi hai? General surgery ke instruments. So artery forceps is used everywhere. And if you do not get this right, trust me, it will be a big blunder in the exam. That's why I am putting this artery forceps, because artery forceps ke bina koi surgery hoti nahi hai. Theek hai? So this is your artery forceps. This is the straight one and you have the curved one and you have a ratchet over here to hold the artery forceps. So this is used as a hemostat. Theek hai? Now moving on to our next question. So can you identify this? Yes, very good. So you can see there are teeth over here, one side 4 teeth and one side 5 teeth. So this is your Allis tissue forceps. Can you tell me the use of Allis tissue forceps, guys? What is it used for holding, Allis tissue forceps? Yes, it is used for holding tough structures. Can example of tough structures in OBGY related surgeries? Good morning, Dr. Arush. Example of tough structures? Yes. So specifically the rectus sheath. Okay, rectus sheath. So you want, when you want to hold the rectus sheath, you will use this Allis tissue forceps. Echo is coming. Is that too bad for you guys? If the echo is coming, or is it okay? The thing is, the room is too big, so that is why the echo keeps coming. All right. I think it's okay. We can continue. Correct. Okay, now moving on to a more OBGY related instrument. Yes, IR spatula. Can anyone tell me the use of IR spatula? Where do we use IR spatula? Pap smear from cervix, absolutely correct. Okay, now can you tell me why is it made up of wood? They may ask you, why is it made up of wood? Why is it made up of wood? Not reactivity, but wood has a porous surface, okay? So that porous surface helps the exfoliated cells to stick to the IR spatula. The second thing is, Once I get the exfoliated cells, in this case, where do I put it? Can anyone tell me what do I do with the exfoliated cells from Meyer spatula? I put it in something else that is called as a Koplik's jar. Okay, I put it in a Koplik's jar which has a fixative of ether plus alcohol. Okay, so you can either put it on a glass slide or you can put it in a Koplik's jar which has fixation of ether plus alcohol. Okay, and then you can watch the cells. Okay, now tell me, what is the broad end used for? This end is used for taking the cervical smear, pap smear. What is this end used for, the broad end? What can you do with the broad end? Any idea? Very good, Dr. Grace. So in the broad end, you can take a sample from the lateral part of the vagina to know the hormonal status of the patient. Okay. So whenever you want to know the ERPR status of the patient, from this broad end, you can take a little bit of a sample from the lateral vagina and know the ERPR status. Clear? So this is everything about our IR spatula. Okay, next one. Identify what is this and where is it used in OBGYN. Very good. So this is your Babcock's forceps. And what is Babcock's forceps used for? It is used for holding tubular structures. So what is the tubular structure that we are interested in holding in OBGYN? Yes, very good. It is your fallopian tube. Okay, great. Next one. Identify this. Very specific for OBGYN. And tell me what surgery it is used in. Very good. Absolutely correct. So this is used in lap tubal ligation. Can anyone tell me the name of this instrument? Name of this instrument used in lap tubal ligation? Okay, so it is called as a band applicator. All right, it is called as a band applicator. So what does this band applicator do? The band applicator, you can see over here the tip, how it is. So the tip will hold a silastic ring, and that silastic ring will be put on the fallopian tubes during the tubal ligation. Okay, so you put that silastic ring and you tighten the ring to, in order to close down the fallopian tube. So this is your example of band applicator. Okay. All right, next one, very easy. Yes, this is called as Cusco speculum. Now, can you tell me the other name for Cusco speculum? Suppose they don't give you Cusco speculum in the exam. They give you another option for this. So what is the other name for Cusco speculum? It is related to one of the animals. It looks like the mouth of a, it looks like the mouth of a duck. Okay, so this is also called as duck speculum. It is also called as duck speculum. Okay, give me any two uses. What is it used for? What is it used for? Very good. When you want to take a pap smear, it's a self-retaining speculum. So you can use it for pap smear. You can use it for copper T or any IUCD insertion or removal. And it is also used for general examination of the vagina. Okay. All right, very good. Now tell me what is the next instrument over here. Again, very similar between surgery and OBGYN, but extremely important. Okay, so this is our Doyen's retractor. How do we remember this? You can make a D, ulta D with this. Okay, so this is our Doyen's retractor. Okay, can you identify the next one? Dewar's retractor, very good. Doyen's retractor, Dewar's retractor, and this. This one, it looks like it has the Doyen's retractor and then on the sides it has something else. Yes, this is Balfour's self-retaining retractor. Balfour's self-retaining retractor. Okay, now out of, and this one. I'm showing you all the different types of retractors that are used in OBGYN as well as general surgery. This one. Yes, again, this is Dewar's retractor only. You can see the picture over here and here. This is the same. So this is Dewar's retractor only. Just trying to confuse you guys. Okay, and this. Now, this is not Dewar's retractor again. It's not Morrison. Morrison is more broader than this. Okay, Morrison's retractor is much broader than this. This is not very broad. So this is your Langenbach right angle retractor. Okay, absolutely correct. This is at right angles. So this is your Langenbach's right angle retractor. Okay, now out of all of them, which is the one that will retract superficial structures and which is the one that will retract deeper structures? So I'll quickly show you the pictures again. Doyens, Beavers, Balfour's, Beavers again, and Langenbach. So which is the one that will help in retracting the deeper structures? Yes, very good. So it is Beavers retractor that will help in retracting the deeper structures. So that's how I always remember Beaver and deeper. Okay. All right, moving on to our next picture. Identify this scissors. Only two types of scissors you need to remember in OBGY, very important. What is the name of this scissors? Yes, so this is Mayo's straight scissors. Okay, so if you want to cut through any tissue, if you want to cut through the uterus, cervix, anything, you can use Mayo's straight scissors. And there is another pair of scissors which is very important in OBGY. Can you tell me what is this? Yes, absolutely correct. So when you have this angle, you should know that this is your episiotomy scissors. Okay, this is your episiotomy scissors. Okay, now tell me, in episiotomy scissors, they can ask you to identify and they'll tell you at what time of vaginal delivery or vaginal birth will you use this instrument. So when is the exact time that you will give an episiotomy cut? Absolutely correct. So at the crowning of the head, at the crowning of the head, you will use your episiotomy scissors. Okay. Now, how will you give the cut? In what direction will you give the cut? Yes. So your cut will be in the direction of mediolaterally. Okay. You will give the cut in the direction of mediolaterally. Now, once the cut is given and the baby is out, then you have to suture the episiotomy wound. So what are the three layers in which you will suture the episiotomy wound? Yes, very good. So vaginal mucosa from inside to outside. Okay, from inside to outside, you will have vaginal mucosa. Then you will have your perineal muscles. And finally, you will have the skin. Barabar. So this is how you will carry your episiotomy. Now tell me, for the median cut, what is the problem if I give a median cut? In episiotomy, if I give a median cut, what will I cut through? What will I cut through? Damage to what? Yes, damage to anal sphincter. Okay, what is the audio issue, guys? You can tell me. There's just a little bit of an echo, but I hope that you guys are able to understand what I'm saying. Some brash sound is there. Air blowing. Okay, wait one second. I'll just switch off the fan. So maybe that will make things easier for you guys. Okay. Yeah, one second. Rush, rush, push. Now, just for you guys, I'm working without a fan now. Horrible. Okay. Abhi theek hai. भूत नहीं है प्लीज मैं अकेले कह रही हूँ यहाँ पे मुझे भूत भूत नहीं बोलो ओके चलो चलो अभी भी आ रही है आवाज ओके आई डोंट नो व्हाई आई एम नॉट इन महाराष्ट्र ठीक है चलो नाउ लेट्स गो ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रूमेंट टाइम पास करने के लिए तुम लोग को बहुत ये हाँ ओके लेट्स गो ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रूमेंट व्हाट इज दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड व्हाट इज इट्स यूज Myomectomy clamp nahi hai. It clamps one of the other structures of the OBGY. Kya kya hai? Uterus hai, then you have the cervix and then you have the vagina. One of these structures is clamped by this. It's a vaginal clamp. Okay, so it is I'll write it over here. It is Barclay-Bonnie's vaginal clamp. Now, can anyone tell me in which surgery we use this Barclay-Bonnie's vaginal clamp? Any idea? Okay, so this is used in Werdheim's hysterectomy. Okay, so before you cut the uterus, you clamp the vagina with this clamp. Okay, so before cutting the uterus, you will clamp the vagina with this clamp. So remember this. How can you remember this? Iska B ban sakta hai, B. So Barclay and Bonnie, both are BB. Okay, Barclay Bonnie's vaginal clamp. Okay, next one over here. Very important. Very good. So this is your punch biopsy forceps. Punch biopsy forceps use. What is the use of your punch biopsy forceps? Yes. Kidhar ka punch biopsy loge? Cervical punch biopsy. Absolutely correct. When you're suspecting cervical cancer. Okay. Next one. Dilator, yeah, you're close. It's not a dilator, but it's something that you put in one of the tubings only. Abhi sound ko chodo, tum log sirf dekho. Achha, you all are saying that it is a sound. It's not a sound. It's not a uterine sound. I'll show you the uterine sound also. You'll see it ahead. Very good, Soptic. Okay, so this is a metal urethral catheter. Of course, it is not used anymore. But initially, they used to use this for draining the urine from the female urethra. Okay, so now we use Foley's. But initially, they used to put this in the female urethra and they used to drain the urine out of it. So can you see there is a hole over here? So ye hole mein se urine bahar aata tha and like this. But what is the problem with this? It can be extremely traumatic. Okay, so that is why we don't use it anymore. But can you tell me any advantage of this as compared? It would not retain. It was not for permanent use. It was just like, just put it in the urethra, drain whatever urine is there and you will be done with it. Remove it. Like a simple red rubber catheter. Okay, so the problem with this was that it used to cause a lot of injuries to the urethra, but it would not go all the way to the bladder. So it would protect the bladder, but it would destroy the urethra. Okay, so you have to identify what is more important for you, the bladder or the urethra, and then accordingly use Foley's or metal catheter. Okay, aaj ophthal bhi hai, last mein 10 ophthal instrument bhi hai. Okay, acha, abhi ye identify karo. Yes, very good. Tell me the full name. What is this? Ovard's what? Ovard's self-retaining posterior vaginal speculum. What is the use? Ovard's self-retaining posterior vaginal speculum. What is the use of this speculum? Yes, so you use it in vaginal hysterectomy. And you also use it in anterior colporrhaphy. Okay? Absolutely correct. You can use it in both these surgeries. Where will you use it? You will put it over the posterior vaginal wall. Okay? Posterior vaginal wall pe you will put this speculum. Sorry. Okay, this one. Very easy to identify. Again, use both in general surgery and OBGYN. Yes, green Armitage forceps. How will you identify it? From the tip. Okay, so if you see the tip is ekdam aise flat. So can you tell me where and for what do we use green Armitage forceps? We use it a lot in one of the surgeries which is very important in OBGY, and that is your LSCS. Okay, so can you tell me in LSCS what do we use it for? Yeah, you can hold tissue structures also with this, but most importantly, it is used as a hemostat in LSCS. Okay. Now, how will you use it as a hemostat in LSCS? If you see, it has a very broad end, so it can hold the vessel and crush it very nicely in between it. If you see the normal hemostat, it has a very narrow end. Okay, so usko crush karne mein itna chota sa area ko hi crush karega, but this will hold the entire vessel like this, aise, and must mein crush it. Okay, all right. Ye to sabko aana chahiye abhi. Yes, this is Haggar's dilator. Very good. What is Haggar's dilator used for? What do you dilate with Haggar's dilator? Yes, so you can dilate the cervix in case of cervical stenosis. Can anyone tell me the other name of Haggar's dilator? it's named after another Indian scientist. Any idea? Okay, it is also called as the Das's dilator. Absolutely correct, Ritima. It is also called as the Das's dilator. Okay, ye batao kya? नहीं साउंड नहीं है मुझे पता था सब लोग यूट्राइन साउंड बोलेंगे आई विल शो यू यूट्राइन साउंड ओके लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ डायलेटर ओनली व्हाट इज द नेम बट ओके इट इज कॉल्ड एज द हॉकिंस एम्बलर डायलेटर अगेन यूज्ड फॉर द सेम थिंग यूज्ड फॉर डायलेटिंग द सर्विक्स इन केस ऑफ सर्वाइकल स्टेनोसिस बट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम हेगास डायलेटर के हेगास डायलेटर एंड हॉकिंस एम्बलर डायलेटर All right. Both of these dilators used specifically in OBGY. That's why you should know both of them. Okay? Okay. ये बताओ. ये क्या? Absolutely correct. So this is Cocker's forceps. Any idea what is Cocker's forceps used for in OBGY? Amniotomy. Very good. So what is amniotomy also called as? Amniotomy is also called as artificial rupture of membranes. अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड का कुछ करते हैं इसके साथ सो यू कैन क्लैम द अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड ऑल्सो विद दिस विद कॉकर्स फोर्सेप्स ओके सो नाउ वी हैव दोस अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड क्लैम्स उसका भी मैं तुमको फोटो दिखाऊंगी आगे जाके बट यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज द कॉकर्स फोर्सेप्स टू क्लैम द अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड ओके एंड एनी थिंग दैट वी कैन यूज इट इन हिस्ट्रेक्टमी कैन वी होल्ड एनी स्ट्रक्चर विद दिस ओके सो इन हिस्ट्रेक्टमी वी कैन होल्ड द फैलोपियन ट्यूब विद दिस ओके Alright, so this is a very important instrument because it's being used in three important surgeries. Okay, now whenever we do instruments, now you should always see ek to LSCS, ek vaginal delivery, and what is the third important thing? Umbilical cord manipulation. So all these three are important surgeries which are done day in and day out. Okay, so as a result of this, you should know all the instruments that are being used in these surgeries. That's why I put some clamps also. I put some. forceps also which I use in those surgeries, retractors also, so that kuch bhi pooch le, uske aaju baaju you should know. Okay, it's okay if you traumatize the tubes. Anyways, you're removing the uterus, so even if you traumatize the fallopian tubes, it's absolutely fine. Okay, all right. Wow, we have someone called as Mat Poocho who has joined in, so I cannot ask him any questions. Yes, absolutely correct. So this is called as Karman syringe. What is Karman syringe used for? What is the use of Karman syringe? Two uses. One is for menstrual regulation. And can you aspirate anything out of this? If I want to take a sample of anything, can I aspirate anything? Yes. So if I want to do endometrial sampling, so I can do endometrial aspiration with this, with Karman syringe. Okay. All right. Next one. Oh, one thing I forgot to ask you, what is the capacity of the Karman syringe? Capacity? Yes, 50 ml. Absolutely correct. Okay, what is this? This is not Leach Wilkinson cannula. Yes, very good, Dr. Gray. So this is your Rubin's insufflation cannula. Rubin's insufflation cannula. Can you tell me what is the use of Rubin's insufflation cannula? Yes, so in hysterosalpingography, okay, yes, I will show the metal catheter. So in hysterosalpingography, you will put the dye through it, okay, and you will look at the fallopian tubes ka anatomy. So if the fallopian tubes are patent, you will be able to see the patency of the fallopian tubes when you insufflate the fallopian tubes with the dye using the Rubin's insufflation cannula. Okay, understood? All right, so someone wanted to see the metal catheter. Here, this is your metal urethral catheter. My God, I just realized looking at the slide how bad my handwriting is. Okay, I'm just going to write it in caps lock for you guys, okay? All right. Okay, so this is your Rubin's insufflation cannula. Now, there was one person. Okay, now two things they can ask you. What is the dye used in hysterosalpingography? And what is the dye used in laparoscopic surgeries in which you are checking the patency of the fallopian tubes. So there are two different dyes that are used in this case. So what is the dye that is used in hysterosalpingography? It's not methylene blue. It's not barium. It is urographin. Okay, urographin. And what is the dye used in laparoscopic surgeries in which you are checking the patency of the tubes? Yeah, my spelling of urographin is wrong. Suman's is right. Okay. In laparoscopic surgeries, you will use methylene blue. Okay. All right. Yes. So this one over here is your Leech-Wilkinson hysterosalpingography cannula. Okay. What is it used for? Leech-Wilkinson hysterosalpingography cannula. Same thing as Rubin's insufflation cannula. You use it to check patency of your fallopian tubes. Okay. Next one. See, it has two things. With the ends, it can hold something and it can also inject dye. So what does this use? It can inject dye, it can insufflate, it can also hold the structure. So what is this called as? Any idea? Okay. So this is a uterine manipulator. Okay, it is a uterine manipulator. It is used in all kinds of laparoscopic surgeries to hold the uterus. And if you want to inject something into the uterus like a dye, you can inject it from this end. Okay, so this is a uterine manipulator used in laparoscopic surgeries. Okay, what is this? Very easy. And very important, because this is used in MTP. It's not sponge holding forceps. It has a much bigger ending as compared to sponge holding forceps. And this side is curved. It's not Babcock's. In MTP, we use it. Any idea? Anyone? Okay. So this is ovum holding forceps. Okay. Now, can you tell me why do we use ovum holding forceps in MTP? You all will be like, ma'am, ovum kaise nikal rahe MTP mein? Yes. So if you want to remove the retained products of conception when you're doing an MTP, at that time you will use this ovum holding forceps. Okay? All right. Next one. All of them look very similar, na? But they're very classical pictures that can come in the exam. This is named after an Indian scientist. It's dilator, yes, very good, Ash. So this is Purandare's dilator. What is the important thing that will help you identify Purandare's dilator? Anything very specific over here that will help you identify the dilator? Okay, I'll tell you. Purandare's dilator mein pura andar nahi jata hai. पूरा अंदर नहीं जाता है. सो व्हाट स्टॉप्स इट फ्रॉम पूरा अंदर जाने में? ओके, सो देयर इज दिस गार्ड ओवर हियर. ठीक है, सो द मिनट इट द गार्ड रीचेस द सर्विक्स, इट विल नॉट अलाउ यू टू गो फुली इनसाइड. सो दिस विल प्रोटेक्ट फ्रॉम परफोरेशन. ओके, सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस पूरा अंदर ही पूरा अंदर नहीं जाता है, ऐसे याद रखो. ठीक है, ऑलराइट, वेरी इजी. But tell me the full name. It's not a curate. कुछ भी हाँ, ये तो तुम लोग ने अपने OBGY वाइवा में भी सीखा होगा. What anterior vaginal wall retractor? Yes, absolutely correct. Okay, Sims anterior vaginal wall retractor. What is it used for? Sims anterior vaginal wall retractor. Use. Yes, absolutely correct. Very good. Suman has mentioned it very nicely. So it is used with, along with Sims speculum, to examine the cervix and vagina. 100% you all must have seen this being used in OBGY postings. Dekha hai ya nahi dekha hai? Ek do cheeze important hai. Okay, so now what about this one? This is another very important instrument. सिम्स और कस्कोस, क्या तुम लोग भी कस्को स्पेकुलम वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन नो इन द बिगिनिंग, देन हाउ यू आर मेकिंग दीज मिस्टेक्स. दिस इज योर कस्को स्पेकुलम, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज योर डक स्पेक्युलम बिकॉज द एंड इज लाइक अ डक, ओके, एंड दिस इज योर सिम स्पेक्युलम. वॉट इज द अदर डिफरेंस बिटवीन सिम स्पेक्युलम एंड कस्को स्पेक्युलम? Cuscus is self-retaining. Okay, sims you have to hold. So you hold the sim speculum like this and the anterior vaginal wall retractor like that, and you can look into the vagina and cervix. Okay, so this is your sim speculum. Now tell me, sim speculum will retract which part of the vagina? Anterior wall or posterior wall? Yes, very good. It will retract the posterior wall of the vagina. Okay, so anterior wall kya retract karega fir? पोस्टीरियर वॉल तो मैं से पुश कर रही हूँ, तो एंटीरियर वॉल रिट्रैक्ट करने के लिए व्हाट विल यू यूज? यू विल यूज द सिम्स एंटीरियर वेजाइनल वॉल रिट्रैक्टर. ठीक है, यू ऑल मस्ट हैव सीन दिस मेनी टाइम्स. एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. अभी ये बताओ क्या है, फिर से मुझे पता है सब लोग बोलेंगे साउंड 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 साउंड, बट इट्स नॉट. लुक एट द एंड, इट हैज सम सेरेशंस एंड ब्लेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. कैन्यूला, व्हाट कैन्यूला? आईवी कैन्यूला. Suman, you're right. The first word you said is correct. What is the second word? Suction what? And when is it used? Okay, so this is called as a suction curette. Okay, now I will give you a hint. It is used in MTP. Can you tell me it is used in MTP of specifically what? Yes, absolutely correct. So in first trimester MTP, when you want to remove a vesicular mole, okay, so this we use this suction curette. So basically it will suction out the mole, okay, so this is used for that. Now the it comes in many different sizes, so the size is dependent on the outer diameter, and you will choose the size equal to number of weeks of pregnancy, number of weeks of pregnancy. Okay, all right, this one, identify this, very important, another very important surgery that is done in OBGYN, and this is used for that. Yes Suman, the pressure that we use is 16, that absolutely correct. Ye kya hai batao, is a C shape jo aise aa raha hai, hook type, hook. Hook, 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 are baba rook. Seeing first time. Okay. So this is Shirodkar's cerclage needle. Shirodkar's cerclage needle. What is it used for? Cerclage needle to remove IUCD. No. Agar naam likha hai to, yes. So it is used for the case of cervical cerclage. And when do you do cervical cerclage? You do it in case of threatened abortion, whenever you have cervical incompetency, correct? In cervical incompetency, if there is threatened abortion, you will do a cervical cerclage. Okay, so this is used for cervical cerclage. Now they can ask you that what is the kind of material of suture that you will use in case of cervical cerclage. So any idea? Non-absorbable, yes, it is morcellin tape. Okay, morcellin tape is the kind of suture material that you will use for cervical cerclage. Okay. All right, next one. Identify this. Yes, absolutely correct. So ये सबको पता है, देखा होगा बहुत बार. So this is your uterine curette. What is the use? Give me any 2-3 uses of uterine curette. Yes. So one side of it will be blunted, one side of it will be sharpened. Okay, so what is it used for? It is not used for checking the uterine length. It is used for taking biopsy, and it is used for doing check curettage. Check curettage, dilatation and curettage. Okay, then for scraping the endometrial cavity, if you want to take cells, all these things you use the uterine curette. Okay, next one. Yes, complication is Asherman syndrome. Absolutely correct. This is a little difficult for you guys. So I can tell you this, you can tell me what could be the use of it. Okay, so these are your uterine dressing forceps. It looks like any other forceps, so it's difficult to identify. So can you tell me uterine dressing forceps are used for what? Any idea? Absolutely correct. So if you want to do uterine packing, or if you want to clean the uterus with a swab, okay, so uterine swabbing with gauze piece. So in that case, you can use the uterine dressing forceps, okay? So you can use, you can put a gauze in between the two ends and you can roll the gauze around the uterus, inner part of the uterus, okay? Yes, in PPH, or if you want to just clean the uterus after the check curettage, then you can use this for that, okay? All right, next one. Abhi batao. Everyone has been waiting to answer this. Finally, this is uterine sound. Okay, finally, it is your uterine sound. How do you identify this? Iska jo end hai na, U jaise hai, U for uterine sound. Okay, and then it will have these three lines in it. So you can also remember it as these three lines are like the lines of a harmonic. Okay, harmonium. Okay, so those three lines, harmonium produces a sound, correct? So this is like uterine sound. Okay, all right, what is the use of a uterine sound? Yes, so it measures uterocervical length. What else does it measure? Absolutely correct. It checks whether your uterus is antiverted or retroverted. Anything else that you can do with a uterine sound? Okay, you can measure the length of the cervix. Okay, already mentioned over there. You can feel for any pathology if there is. Okay, so if you have polyps or something, no, it cannot be used as a dilator. It's not that thick enough. But if you have any polyp or if you have any fibroid, you will be able to feel it inside the cavity. Okay, or what is this? This is not Babcock. This is much bigger than a Babcock. The ends is bigger than a Babcock. Yes, very good, Dr. Grace. So this is Lane's tissue forceps. What is Lane's tissue forceps used for? Absolutely correct. What can you hold with Lane's tissue forceps and for which surgery can it be used? It can be used for holding a polyp in polypectomy. It can be used for holding a fibroid in myomectomy. Okay. All right. This, it has this rubber tip at the end to prevent trauma. So it has atraumatic ends. Myoma clamp, no. You're protecting something much more important with this. You hold one of the structures. Uterus hold karenge, vagina hold karenge, or cervix hold karenge. Batao. With this. Uterus, vagina, or cervix? No. You will hold the uterus with this. Okay, so the uterus is very bulky and you don't want to traumatize it. So you have these rubber tip ends at the end. Okay, so you can use this as uterus holding forceps. Okay, so it will help you to hold and steady the uterus. Any surgery, you want to do hysterectomy, you want to do any kind of diagnostic procedure, okay, you can hold the uterus using this. Absolutely correct. Ye kya? Yes, very good, Riddhima. Superb. So this is your cervical occlusion clamp. Can you tell me in which surgery do you use the cervical occlusion clamp? Laparotomy? No. Okay. Yes, absolutely correct. When you want to check the fallopian tube patency. Okay. So what do you do in that case to check the fallopian tube patency? First, you have to occlude the cervix. Nahi to whatever dye you give will come out through the cervix. Okay. So you occlude the cervix, then you give the dye. So the dye will spread upwards into the fallopian tubes. Otherwise, what will happen? By gravity, usually the dye will fall down into the cervix. So if you occlude the cervix with the cervical occlusion clamp, the dye will go up into the fallopian tubes and it will help you check the patency of the fallopian tubes. All right. Okay. Next, what is this? One of the very important surgeries. Very good, Manihai. So this is Bonnie's myomectomy clamp. Okay. Bonney's myomectomy clamp. So what does this myomectomy clamp do? Absolutely correct. So it will clamp the uterine artery. So by clamping the uterine artery, what will you do? You will reduce the blood flow to the fibroids. As a result of this, you will have less bleeding during surgery. Okay. Are you guys getting bored? Itne sare OBGYN instruments dekhke. But you won't have to look anywhere else now for OBGYN instruments. So in one class only, you will be able to complete all your OBGYN instruments. Okay. So around 5-6 instruments of OBGYN left, and then we have 10 instruments of ophthalm. Okay. Arush is getting bored. Okay. Now this thing, if you have a quick look at it, it has a hook at the end. So the hook can use it is can be used for what? Myomectomy. No, it's a very small hook. So what can you remove with this? Very good, Virendra. Okay, so this is a loop hook. It is called as a loop hook, and it is used for IUCD. IUCD removal. Acha, Arush is saying no need to look anywhere else. Okay, fine. Okay, next, identify these two things, very important on point of general surgery as well as OBGY. They can be asked many a times. Yes, so this one over here that you can see is varis needle. And what is the use of varis needle? What does varis needle do? Yeah, varis needle will create pneumoperitoneum. Okay, varis needle is used for creating pneumoperitoneum. And what can you see on the other side? If varis needle is used for creating pneumoperitoneum, what can you see on the other side? This instrument. So this is your trocar with cannula. Okay, now you can't see the cannula over here, it's inside, but this is your trocar with cannula. So you will put all your laparoscopic instruments through this trocar and cannula. So it will act like a guide to put the laparoscopic instruments. Okay, all right, what is this? Too many forceps you all have seen today. It's not Allis tissue forceps. That Allis tissue forceps is not curved like this. Okay. So this is your valsalum. Very good, PJ. Valsalum. Okay. And what is the valsalum used for? What do you grasp with the valsalum? For holding cervical lip. Very good. So you grasp the cervix with the valsalum. When you want to insert IUCD, when you want to take biopsy, if you want to do MTP, in any of these procedures, you can use the valsalum for it. Okay. Absolutely correct. What is this? Very, very important, super important. Very good, Arush. So this is your Wrigley's forceps. Wrigley's forceps. What is the use of Wrigley's forceps? What is the use? Yes, so it is used for forceps delivery. Okay, so it is used for forceps delivery. So you will hold it around both sides of the head. What is the problem with using Wrigley's forceps? Any issue with this? What can happen to the fetal head? Traumatic. So, hoga kya, sir? Caput succedaneum hoga? Very good, Soptic. So, you won't have caput succedaneum. You will have kyphal hematoma. How will you identify between kyphal hematoma and caput succedaneum? What is the main difference between caput and kyphal? Yes, so the kyphal hematoma will not cross suture lines, while your caput succedaneum will be a diffuse big swelling that can cross suture lines, correct? If the patient has LSCS delivery, can he have kyphal hematoma or caput succedaneum? Yes, in LSCS delivery, can he have kyphal hematoma or caput succedaneum? Okay. So caput succedaneum is usually seen with the vaginal delivery, okay, and your kyphal hematoma is seen with instrumental delivery. So unless the manipulation of the baby has been done very badly while removing the baby through LSCS, you will not see both of them, okay? Yeah. Okay, what is this very funny thing? Yes, this is called as your Pinard's fetoscope, okay? Pinard's fetal stethoscope or fetoscope. So what is it used for? It is used for checking the fetal heart rate. Absolutely correct. Okay. Which part is put over the mother's abdomen and which part is held to the ear? I have marked it as 1 or 2. Tell me which part is held on the ear. Yes, absolutely correct. So this part is put on the maternal abdomen and this part is put over the ear. Okay. Again, very important. Yes, very good. So this is your umbilical cord clamp. We saw one umbilical cord cutting scissors before. So this is the one that is used more commonly now, umbilical cord clamp. And what is this? Sorry, we saw one clamp before. What is this? Yes, so this is the umbilical cord cutting scissors. Kitna funny dikhta hai na ye? Umbilical cord cutting scissors. Towel clamp aise nahi dikhta hai, baap re. Okay? Okay, so this is your umbilical cord clamp and umbilical cord cutting scissors. Okay. Never saw these. That's why I'm keeping all these classes, which will help you see the things that you have missed out in your preparation. बस नहीं अच्छा लास्ट 7-8 फोटोज है ऑफ्थाल का भी करना है ना यस सो दिस इज योर वेंट्यूस वेंट्यूस एंड व्हाट इज योर वेंट्यूस यूज फॉर दिस पार्ट दिस इज द कप दैट यू विल पुट ऑन द हेड ऑफ द फीटस सो यू कैन सी ओवर हियर ओके सो दिस इज यूज फॉर वैक्यूम डिलीवरी ओके चलो ऑफ्थाल फटाफट से बताओ भी Is it crescent blade or is it something else? Okay, identify between this and this. This is a blunt edge blade and this is a sharp edge blade. So this is your, yeah. So whenever you have a blunt edge blade, then this is your crescent blade. Okay, what is the use of your blunt edge blade or crescent blade? Any idea? Yeah, it is used for creating your scleral flaps. Okay, the blunt edge blade is used for creating your scleral flaps and it is also used for pterygium surgery. Okay, what about this very sharp edge blade? What is this called? Yes, so this is called as your keratome. What is the use of keratome? Sharp edge keratome, where will you take the incision? With the crescent blade, you take incision over the sclera. With the keratome, you take incision over the cornea. Okay, absolutely correct. So you take corneal incisions with the keratome. Absolutely correct. At the end of this, you have a wire. What is this? Yes, very good, Soptic. So this is a wire vectus. What is the use of a wire vectus? Any idea? First of all, tell me in which surgery you use it. Absolutely correct. So wire vectus will help you in taking out the nucleus of the lens. Nucleus of lens. In which surgery? Extracapsular cataract extraction. Okay. Extracapsular cataract extraction. So you can remove the nucleus of the lens in this case. Okay. What is this? Class is lengthy today. Yeah, because we had to do instruments from both OBGYN and ophthal, that's why. Okay, so this is your McPherson's forceps. Okay, so before you all go, I mean, I have 3-4 more instruments to show you in ophthal. But before you all go, at 10 p.m. today, we have a class of instruments in medicine. So we'll be doing all our kinds of spinal needles and your bone marrow biopsy needles, bone marrow aspiration needles. What are the normal instruments that you can see in the medicine hall? Okay, so that is on YouTube. I will be posting the link for that on Telegram. So you guys can join for that at 10 p.m. Okay, all right. So McPherson's forceps, what is it used for? IOL manipulation, okay, yes. And mainly it is used for suturing. Okay, so when you want to suture the cornea, when you want to suture the sclera. So this helps in holding the sutures for that case. Okay, yeah. What is this? Curette, no, not a curette, scoop, okay, so this is called as a chopper, okay, what is a chopper used for? It is for breaking down a lens, so it's used for breaking down nucleus of lens or pulverizing the nucleus of lens in phaco emulsification. Okay, this probe, yes, what probe? What is the name of the probe? Lacrimal probe, very good. It is used for probing the nasolacrimal duct in dactocystorhinostomy. So what is the name of this probe? Any idea? Okay, it is called as your Bowman's probes. Okay, Bowman's probes used for probing your your nasolacrimal duct in dactocystorhinostomy. Okay. What punch, Suman? What do you punch with this? Naam bata. Starts with a K. Looks like AK-47. Okay, so this is Kerrison's bone punch. This is also to take a punch over the bone when you are doing dacrocystorhinostomy. Okay, both these are used in DCR, Bowman's probes, as well as Kerrison's bone punch. Okay, and last one, what is this? It looks like, yes, very good, Riddhima. So this is our lid what? Pura naam nahi batate tum log. Lid spatula. Okay, this is a lid spatula. Can anyone tell me what is the use of a lid spatula? What is the use? No, it's not to elevate. In fact, it is to protect the structures below the lid. Okay, so suppose I'm carrying out any lid surgery. So I will keep the spatula below the lid, okay, and I will protect all the eyeball and the structures below the lid, okay. So either agar surgery hai, to uske andar rakhungi main lid spatula, okay. Yes, absolutely correct. So let's quickly go through all the instruments that we've seen today. OBGY ka to complete ho gaya, ophthal ke thode baki hai, so I will add them in some other class and I will put it for you guys, okay. So this is our artery forceps, curved as well as straight. Okay, then this is your Allis tissue forceps, this is your IR spatula, Babcock's forceps, then always look at the end of the forceps, okay. If you see Babcock's mein itna chota end hai, if you see your Lane's tissue forceps, uska end kitna bada hai, theek hai? Alright, then this is your band applicator for lap TL, this is Cusco speculum, Doyen's retractor, Deaver's retractor, Balfour's self-retaining retractor, Deaver's again, Langenbach's right angle retractor, Mayo straight scissors, episiotomy scissors, Barclay Bonnet's vaginal clamp, punch biopsy forceps, metal urethral catheter, then Orbard's self-retaining posterior vaginal speculum, Green Armitage forceps, Higgard's dilator, Hocken Ambler's dilator, Cocker's forceps, Carmen syringe, Rubin's insufflation cannula, Leach Wilkinson hysterosalpingography cannula, uterine manipulator, omum holding forceps, Purandare's dilator, Sims anterior vaginal wall retractor, Sims speculum, so this is your Sims speculum which you use on posterior vaginal wall retraction, suction curette, Shirodker cerclage needle, uterine curette, uterine dressing forceps, uterine sound, Lane's tissue forceps. Again, if you see the difference between Lane's tissue forceps, ovum forceps and your Babcock's, very different from the end, okay. Uterus holding forceps, cervical occlusion clamp, Bonnie's myomectomy clamp, loop hook, Berry's needle, trocar with cannula, Valsalum, Rigler's forceps, Pinard's fetal stethoscope, umbilical cord clamp, umbilical cord cutting scissors, Ventus for vacuum delivery. This is how your vacuum delivery is carried out. This is your crescent blade in use for elevating the scleral flaps in ophthal surgery. Keratome for taking corneal incisions. Wire vectis, McPherson's forceps, chopper, Bowman's probes, Kerrison's bone punch, and lid spatula. Okay, is that clear? All right. PDF mein writing nahi samajh aati. Okay, you saw the ABG and it was useful, very good. Okay, so you know what, I've had this complaint of handwriting a lot. I'm sorry, the thing is I just want to do like so many pictures and things for you guys that I write very quickly so that we don't waste time. So I will make it a habit to write everything in caps lock so that you all are able to see it. Okay. Sab kuch acha hai, bahut very good. Okay. Yes, 10 p.m. we have class on instruments in medicine. So I will leave the link for that on Telegram. So instruments in medicine and ophthal and dermat also I've written, but unfortunately I was not able to make the matter for ophthal and dermat. So I will take that at some other time. Very good, Suman. It's very nice. And Telegram, I think you can message me on Telegram. I will reply to your message. Okay. Okay. Now, thank you so much, guys. Now, how do you use this correctly? Download this PPT at the end of it and use this PDF for your use. Now, this is very useful for those who are giving the exam this time as well as next year. So, ye sab download karke na ek folder mein rakha karo in your computer. And then this is something which is very volatile. So, few days before the exam, you can revise it. Anything else that you guys want me to take in this TMTI series? Images and anything else? Mnemonics. Okay, x-rays, I have taken a class on YouTube already, so you can watch it. Soch ke group mein batayenge, theek hai, that will be a good idea. Theek hai, mujhe soch ke 100% group mein batao ki kya kya karna hai, and then we will be able to manage our time well. Case-based scenarios of anesthesia. Okay, next week I am planning an anesthesia revision special class. So not case based scenario, but we'll be doing a quick revision of anesthesia. Okay. All right. X-rays, mnemonics. Theek hai. Theek hai, chalega. Okay. And remember, if you guys want me to cover anything from any subject, preferably not biochemistry, बाकी सब छोड़ के कुछ भी है, सो यू कैन एनी टाइम मैसेज मी ऑन टेलीग्राम एंड लेट मी नो व्हाट यू वांट मी टू कवर टुमारो. द थिंग इज आई हैवंट प्लान्ड एनीथिंग फॉर टीएमटीआई सीरीज, सो आई वाज एक्चुअली वेटिंग टू आस्क यू गाइस व्हाट यू ऑल वांट टू बी कवर्ड, बट आई विल सी थ्रू द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स फॉर द नीट पीजी एग्जाम एंड आई विल मेक द क्लास एंड आई विल टेक इट फॉर यू गाइस. ऑलराइट, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग मी टुडे. फिजियो लास्ट मिनट रिविजन, ठीक है, आई कैन ट्राई डूइंग दैट. And Monday we will be having some plus classes on an academy, so you can join for that also. Hello, jao khana khao, and I will see you at 10 p.m. that is in 45 minutes on YouTube for medicine instruments. Okay. All right. Bye bye.